Hello, everyone. My name is George Gurgiev. I'm a product manager at NVIDIA, focus on our desktop workstation OEM solutions, and that includes our NVIDIA RTX PRO lineup of products. So I'll take you through some of the things that are coming very soon, as well as a quick tour of what we've got today and where we're headed in the future as well, a little sneak preview at the end. But first, I wanted to touch on the unified platform for enterprise AI and graphics that is the NVIDIA RTX PRO platform. There is a new brand coming here as well. And so previously, many years ago, we used the Quadro brand to represent our professional lineup. And then we used NVIDIA RTX, and now we're moving to NVIDIA RTX PRO. And so the intent here is to make it a lot easier to differentiate between, if somebody's talking about RTX as a technology or RTX as used in other product lines, now you'll know with RTX PRO, specifically talking about the professional workstation lineup of GPU products. So we're not renaming anything similar to what Ken just outlined on the Dell side. We're not renaming the existing products. This is a future looking thing, starting with Blackwell generation, as you see here. All right, so that's the new NVIDIA RTX PRO brand with all that same value and brand promise that we've had for years in the professional lineup and continuing to increase as we go forward. So we have this unified platform, meaning whether you're doing AI development, running AI applications, or running AI augmented applications, right? Or developing graphics or using visualization software packages, the NVIDIA RTX PRO platform provides you the ability to scale that work, gives you the libraries, the SDKs, the tools to build on it and expand it anywhere that your business needs to go. And that includes things you see here, laptops equipped with RTX PRO GPUs, desktop workstations equipped with one or more RTX GPUs, and then even servers going beyond with high density scalable solutions. And there's things that go beyond this chart as well in either direction. If you have a need for smaller, more compact things, or even larger, cloud scale things, the unified platform lets you build once and be able to deploy and scale wherever it needs to go. Now, you notice that Blackwell is listed here, and I'll get to what's new in Blackwell. But first, I wanted to mention, show a quick look of what we've got shipping today. So all of these products are available today. They're available throughout the Dell portfolio that Ken went over as well. And so just to let you know, Ada generation represents the current generation of our RTX product line. But looking ahead at Blackwell, we recently announced this in the professional space during GTC a few weeks ago. I wanted to take you through a few highlights here. Blackwell represents a massive gen-to-gen upgrade in terms of not just performance, but also capabilities and what you're able to do here. And so there's a lot of information here, and I'm not going to be able to go through all of it, but we introduced new cores across the board, including new tensor cores, delivering up to 4,000 AI tops of throughput for cutting edge AI models. We've also introduced support for things like 4-bit floating point in order to run newer models with a lower memory footprint and with much higher throughput. So in other words, AI is even better here. When it comes to our traditional graphics processing and rendering capabilities, huge improvements as well in terms of performance, and with up to 96 gigabytes of GPU memory in a single card, the canvas is now double what it was in the previous generation, with 48 gigabytes offered in the 6000 Ada, for example. In addition to doubling that GPU memory, we've also doubled memory bandwidth up to 1.8 terabytes per second in Blackwell with our Blackwell 6000 class GPUs. There's a number of other improvements as well, but really it boils down to new performance, new capabilities. With that new GPU architecture, we're introducing a number of new products built on Blackwell as well to cover the various segments, including SOLIDWORKS users, of course. And so one difference here is we'll have two products named RTX PRO 6000 in the desktop space. So we're introducing a new form factor with RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell Workstation Edition. It's a 600 watt GPU, single card, and it's a bit bigger than today's 6000 Ada. And so it's not necessarily a drop-in compatible replacement. However, we are working very closely with Dell, and they'll have systems available to fully support this and optimize for this platform, or for this new RTX PRO 6000, this new form factor, very soon. We also have the RTX Pro 6000 Max-Q that you see listed here. And that indicates, you know, Max-Q technology, taking that big 600 watt GPU, squeezing it down into a more familiar form factor, the same form factor as today's 6000 Ada, running at 300 watts, but with the same 96 gigabytes of memory and all the same other capabilities that you'd expect from the 6000 class, now in a smaller package than the 600 watt version, and designed for density. So if you have workloads that scale across multiple GPUs, the 6000 Max-Q is your target there. Later on, throughout the summer, we'll roll out the rest of the lineup. We have the RTX Pro 5000, 4500, and 4000. And so we'll share more details on those as we get closer to their release. Looking at the whole lineup here and the full naming, this is what the new RTX Pro lineup will look like. Again, offering solutions in every form factor, whether that's thin and light laptops, small, you know, micro desktops, for example, or large towers, and even beyond. We've got RTX Pro solutions everywhere to meet you where your work needs to go. Let's talk about performance for a moment. So as I mentioned, Blackwell represents a huge performance uplift gen to gen. And so here's a few examples where we're highlighting some of the performance expectations for a variety of different workloads. I mean, you can see for AI work, 3.8x or 2.5x increase compared to RTX 6000 Ada generation. And then for other workflows like video editing, up to 15x compared to RTX 6000 Ada. A huge improvement for anybody working with video. Rendering and graphics is no slouch either. Up to 2.4x improvement over RTX 6000 Ada over today's flagship. Well, what about SOLIDWORKS? Well, let's zoom in on that. So of course, you know, Blackwell is well suited for SOLIDWORKS users. And in this case, this chart here on the right compares our existing lineup. And so this is all the products that are shipping today with the RTX Pro 6000, the new RTX Pro 6000 Blackwell products that are coming very soon, stacked up alongside it. And so you can see here how performance scales very nicely. And again, as I mentioned, we'll have other products as well in the 5000 and the 4000 class, for example, some of those more traditional segments for SOLIDWORKS users. We'll have that data available. But the point is, you can see how we've got nice scaling. So if you're looking for maximum performance, very complex models you're working with, we've got you covered with a full lineup to meet you where your work needs to go. Now, finally, I mentioned there was one more thing. So we're introducing a new category of compute here, specifically tailored for AI users, for AI development. And we've partnered very closely with Dell in order to bring these things to market. And so you could see some an early preview of what these things will look like when they come to the market. Now, if you've heard of, if you saw our announcements at GTC, DGX Spark, DGX Station is what they were called there. Dell's building these into Dell Pro Max with GB10 on the left and Dell Pro Max with GB300. These will be ARM-based CPUs, NVIDIA ARM-based CPUs with an NVIDIA Blackwell GPU in each of them at a very different scale. So the Dell Pro Max with GB10, very small, tiny, compact system, perfect for personal AI development. Up to 128 gigabytes of unified memory, meaning you could run massive models on this thing for development, for fine tuning, for experimentation, for whatever you need to do. On the other end of the spectrum, Dell Pro Max with GB300, 784 gigabytes of unified memory. Great for those multi-model, gigantic, agentic AI and massive LLM models, being able to run those, whether for training or inference. More detail will be coming soon, but just wanted to preview those briefly since this represents a big shift in what's possible in a very small, compact form factor right at your desk, and unlocking a whole new era of AI development.